Good evening. I'm Prableen Gupta, and as promised, I am here in front of you with our first episode of our Sustainable Atmanirbharta series. The series is all about inculcating and absorbing the mindset of becoming Atmanirbhar. What is Atmanirbharta? Sri Narendra Modi has given us this input that, you know, we have to become Atmanirbhar. Atmanirbhar in our actions, Atmanirbhar in getting things done according to the resources that are available with us. But inse bhi pehle, to take care of our actions, to take care of the things which are already available with us and then taking the next step, there is one thing which is required prior to all of this. And that one thing is Atmanirbhar mindset. Pehle, हमारे दिमाग में हमारे माइंड में वो थॉट्स होने चाहिए दैट मेक्स अस बिलीव दैट येस आई कैन डू इट आई एम द वन हु हैज़ द पावर टू चेंज द सिचुएशन और हैंडल द सिचुएशन इन दीज मैनी रिसोर्सेज दैट आई हैव एंड वंस वी हैव एंड पोजेस दैट माइंड सेट द वर्ल्ड इज ऑल आवर्स एंड वी आर गोइंग टू टेक एनी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ वट एवर सिचुएशन दैट कम्स अ वे एंड कम आउट ऑफ इट एज अ वॉरियर सो लेट्स बिगिन टूडे विद दिस फर्स्ट सेशन And I am Prableen Gupta. I am NLP Master Practitioner, Trainer, and International Coach Federation Certified Leadership and Wellness Coach. And I think that is the reason I'm very much inclined towards this Atmanirbharta. And you must have seen my various videos and clippings over personal mastery workshops, personal mastery quotes that I keep on posting. Because I personally believe that if I change myself, if I change the way I work or change the way I deal with the situation will change eventually. So everything lies within me. That is my belief. And I'm glad that I'm able to share this belief and contribute towards changing that belief system for you all also. Let's see how you can benefit out of it. So before we start, there are a few statements that I would like to use. Main subah jaldi uth hi nahi sakti. I'm not in a habit of, you know, sleeping early. My boss is so shrewd ki main uske sath rapport building kar hi nahi sakti hun. My friends are always like that. No one understands me. Main kitna bhi unke sath acche se baat kar lun, khel lun, mil lun, but they will not understand me because they are always like that. Just like my boss. Because wo hamesha problems create karte rehte hain mere liye and that is the reason I am not able to work with full confidence. I cannot quit smoking. Why? Because I'm addicted to it. It's not my cup of tea. It's very difficult. Every time I try, but I then again go back to this habit. It's not my fault. So did you realize something with these statements? It's not that all these statements I am doing it. No, it's not like that. It's just that I'm just trying to relate to these kind of statements that we keep on using on daily basis. For our bosses, for our managers, for our colleagues, for our juniors, for our parents, friends, for our own self, right? So what do you think? When we see these kind of things, ki main to ye kar hi nahi sakti. Kitna bhi koshish kar lo, kitna bhi usse achche se baat kar lo, par aapki uske saath ban hi nahi sakti. When we see these kind of things or repeat these kind of statements, are we Atmanirbhar at that point of time or are we Nirbhar at that point of time? Give it a thought. So, to explain it in a better way, let me share a story with you. There was a manager in a multinational company and one day he was given a task to collect the travel details of all his team members jo uske junior the, jo usko report karte the. So what he did is, he sent an email to all the team members ki please share your travel details with me. Aap kab kab abroad gaye ho ya aap within India bhi kahin pe travel kiye ho to. And after he sent that email, the team members, they replied to him with one of the information or the other of the information, but not the entire information was shared with him. Because of which, usko dubara se mail bhejna pada ki bhai ye cheez missing reh gayi hai, send that to me. Aapka reason of travel missing reh gaya, send that to me. Aapka kaun se hotel mein ruke the, wo aapne nahi bheja, send that to me. And as you know, in every organization, there is a timeline given to everything. So he got delayed in sharing that travel details of his team members with his boss. And then what happened? His boss called him in the room and he said that, what is this? You're not able to do the simple task on time. How can I expect you to complete this project on time then? So the manager, he got really upset and he said, boss, it's not my fault. It's my team. They didn't share the information with me on time. They missed few information and I had to ask for it with them again. So what could I do? So the boss then said that, who do you think is at fault in this case? If you say that it's not my fault, whose fault is this? And he said that my team members, they didn't share the complete information with me. Then the boss simply replied one thing, that you know what? You will never be able to fix any situation. You will never be able to fix any problem if you are dependent on the other person to find a cause, to find a problem that has been created. Till the time you do not feel and believe that the cause lies within you, the cause lies within your style of working, the cause lies within your handling of the situation, till that time you will not be able to find the solution. Think over it, go back and let me know how you can fix such kind of situations in future now. So that manager went this out with this input and thought about it. And he realized he missed on sharing the template with his team members so that all the information that he needed, they could have provided the information in that similar format only. And because of which the things got delayed. So next time onwards, he started using that template for any kind of details that are required from the group of people. And he got the instant reply from all of them without any misses. So in this story, what did he do? Earlier, he was thinking that it was not his fault. But later on, when he thought about it, he realized that the cause lies within him. The solution also lies within him. And when we will find the solution of any problem, when we find the cause of the problem, that is within us. So there are two things in life. Whatever happens with us or to us in our life, it has cause and effect. Cause is the reason and effect is the result. And if you pay deep attention and if you start observing these two words, you will realize that cause is always at the higher end and effect is always dependent on the cause. For example, if Rita eats more, that is the cause, that Rita eats more. Effect will be, what will be the effect? Absolutely, she will gain weight. So gaining weight is a result, but the cause which is causing this result is eating more. Similarly, when I say that my boss is so shrewd that I cannot build rapport with him, that is putting the responsibility on the shoulders of my manager. I cannot take responsibility of my manager because that is his area of concern. But my area of concern is, how can I behave with him in a manner that I don't feel that I have been let down? I have to think that, do I become too submissive when I talk to him? Do I become aggressive when I talk to him? Do I become low on confidence when I talk to him? Do I stutter while talking to him? I have to look into the causes within myself. And the moment I realize that what I am doing that is causing such kind of behavior in other person, I will take the action step that will give me the solution. And this is how the life changes. So cause is always on the higher end. You can call it as a mentor. Cause is always the mentor. And effect is always at the lower end and it is the victim. And ensure that you decide to be the mentor, not the victim. So from now on, if you face any situation where you feel that you are disempowered of dealing with it properly, take a minute. Think that, are you at the cause side? Are you thinking about the reason that has happened because of which this solution has been given to you? And the moment you think, what exactly do you want? And you work on that reason, automatically your effect will change. So if we take the same example of eating more or gaining weight, if my action, if my cause is eating more, which is resulting in gaining weight, the moment I start eating less and moderate, exercising more, then do you think that I will get some different result? Obviously, I will. Or if I'm not getting it, then there may be some medical problem because of which the result is not appropriate. Again, the cause lies within me. That if it is a medical situation, did I sought for any help from the doctor? So again, the cause will be with me. And the moment I work on the cause, my solution, my effect, my results will change. So it is not my fault? No. I am the cause. I will work on that cause and I will change the solution. I will change the effect. So from now on, whenever you find yourself in a tricky situation, just think about the reason. What do you want? And start working towards it. You will automatically get the desirable effect. Thank you for watching and see you next week again with another mindset that we will inculcate in ourselves to become sustainably Atmanirbhar. Have a great evening.